Alrighty guys, and welcome back to Star Wars Review. Today is May 25th, 2023, which means it's the 40th anniversary of Star Wars Episode 6 Return of the Jedi, as it came out on May 25th, 1983. So today I'm going to do like a little celebration video for its 40th anniversary. Obviously, you know I love Star Wars, and the original trilogy is my favorite trilogy, and my three favorite Star Wars movies. Return of the Jedi is either 2 or 3. I kind of switch back and forth between it and A New Hope. The original film being my second or third, Empire Strikes Back is my favorite. But even though it's not my favorite, I still love it to death. There's a lot I do love about the movie. There's some behind-the-scenes stuff I quite like. You know, definitely with titles and whatnot. The working title for the movie was Blue Harvest, which is probably one of the more well-known working titles for a Star Wars movie. And obviously the title of the movie was originally Revenge of the Jedi. So, you know, and obviously they changed it to Return because Revenge isn't the Jedi way as much. Obviously they would eventually use Revenge in the title for Revenge of the Sith, the final prequel trilogy movie. But, you know, I love all those little behind-the-scenes little facts. Obviously the movie, like the other two original trilogy films, was re-released in 1997 with the special editions, which make some changes to those movies. Return of the Jedi has some of the worst changes possible, but it also has ones like Victory Celebration at the end, that change, which I do like that one. But, you know, I do like Yub Nub also. So it was a change that kind of, you know, I could go either way, but obviously there's a lot of stuff on in Jabba's Palace, definitely with the band, what's not good, and shouldn't have been changed. And obviously those special editions, they just re-released them in theaters for the 40th anniversary of the film. I just want to mention that real quick because the poster they made for it was pretty cool. I think the artist's name was Matt Ferguson. It was a cool poster. I'll obviously have it up on the screen and whatnot, but I like that one. But the movie, it's one of my favorite Star Wars movies and just one of my favorite movies of all time. I like the intro parts, kind of, I guess, wrapping up and just actually introducing Jabba the Hutt, you know, because obviously in the first two movies, before the special edition changes, there's a lot of mentions of Jabba the Hutt, but we finally get to actually see him in this movie, and then it kind of wraps it all up while technically introducing him fully for the first time. And, you know, it's a first act, which could have easily been a third act in a movie. But, obviously I love the sail barge scene. Definitely a moment, you know, when they kind of just stand there right before R2 shoots out Luke's new lightsaber, which I'll get to that lightsaber in a moment. But, just that scene beforehand, the tense field, kind of cutting away to each character and whatnot, the music. I love that scene a lot. And then R2 shoots out Luke's new green lightsaber, which I really, really love the look of it. You know, it's probably my favorite lightsaber design. It is kind of similar to Obi-Wan's lightsaber, you know, from New Hope and Revenge of Sith and whatnot. But Luke's, to me, is just cooler. Maybe it's because it's green. Even though I personally like the color blue more than the color green. In fact, green really isn't a color I'm that into. I quite like it on Luke's lightsaber. Obviously, the movie introduces us to Ian McDiarmid as Emperor Palpatine. He was great. I loved him in this movie. And then obviously then throughout all of his other appearances as the character created such a, you know, iconic villain for Star Wars in his movies. Obviously the more iconic one will always be Vader just because he was the original villain. And, you know, just the look of Vader is obviously always going to be more recognizable because it's a look which just stands out more. Also, I love the Ewoks and the Forest Moon of Endor. With the Ewoks, it kind of just like how cute they are, but deep down, they're kind of fucked up little creatures. Obviously, the original ideas were to have it be Wookiees on Kashyyyk, but they had to make do with Ewoks. And even though it would have been really cool to see the Wookiees fight to take down the Empire and whatnot, I do kind of like the Ewoks because of that, because it's just kind of really funny. Like, they're just cute little creatures on the outside, but like I said, deep down, they're pretty fucked up. You know, we see them, you know, kill these stormtroopers. They, like, ease, and, you know, I always find that funny. Obviously, there's a lot of returning characters in this movie, you know, Luke, Han, Leia, Lando, R2 and 3PO, Chewie. Obviously, there's new ones, Palpatine, Jabba the Hutt. Obviously, Vader returns, Boba Fett returns. There are some new minor characters that I like obviously, Ackbar, Crix Maydeen and his terrible-looking beard. We get introduced to Mon Mothma, who's a very minor character in this movie and kind of didn't really get a big starring role in a live-action story until last year with Andor, which, you know, the character in Genevieve O'Reilly actually played the character in Andor was great in that series. But, you know, I love all those characters. But obviously, more the standouts to me are Luke and Vader. I really love the scenes where they're together, seeing Luke get Anakin to come back to the light side was some of my favorite stuff. Obviously, that happens on the Death Star 2, which is kind of a retread of the same thing from A New Hope. But I still enjoy it. And just because it gave me some of my favorite Star Wars moments with, like I just mentioned, stuff with Luke and Vader / Anakin. And the throne room scene where all that goes down. The throne room scene is probably my favorite scene in any Star Wars. Maybe just any movie. I just love it to death. And, you know, because of what I was talking about earlier with Luke and Vader, now with Palpatine, just everything about that moment was perfect for me. I really loved the throne room scene. When that's over, the scene with Luke taking Vader's helmet off was great. Luke lighting the pyre for Anakin. And then those final moments, the victory celebration / yub nub scene, I really love. So, you know, I just really love this movie a lot. So, yeah, not really much else to say there. Obviously, this is a little special video for Return of the Jedi's 40th anniversary. I should also have a review for one comic coming out. They're doing like a 40th anniversary comic series, and I did a review of the next one. It should come out today. It could come out tomorrow. I don't know. You'll eventually find out. But for now, that's going to be it for this one. I've been Star Wars, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.